Hello and welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. You're watching The Big Picture with me, Frank Rausen Pereira. On this day, 22 years ago, India's first BJP Prime Minister, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, was sworn in, thus forming the first Bharatiya Janata Party government at the centre. At a solemn ceremony in Rashtrapati Bhavan, President Shankar Dayal Sharma swore in Vajpayee and 11 cabinet members. Till then, the Congress Party had ruled India for all but 4 years since the country won independence from Britain in 1947. The elections to the 11th Lok Sabha triggered a significant realignment of political forces in India, with All India parties attempting to construct widespread regional coalitions with minor parties in order to secure a central majority. Such political negotiations were to become an increasingly necessary process in Indian politics over the next 2 decades. The election delivered an unclear mandate and resulted in a hung parliament. The result was the worst result for the Congress in history to that date. The BJP became the largest party within the Lok Sabha, a first for a non-Congress party. Following Westminster custom, the President invited Vajpayee as leader of the BJP to form a government. On this edition of The Big Picture, we will look back at the first BJP government to be formed. Joining me on the program today are Kuldip Nayar, veteran journalist, Bhupinder Singh Hooda, former Chief Minister of Haryana, Ashok Tandon, former media advisor to Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Neerja Chowdhury, senior journalist, and V. Dhananjay Kumar, former minister in the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government. Kuldip Nayar, sir, I'd like to begin with you. How was the first BJP government formed in 1996?
I don't know which party. Obviously, it must be BJP party. But Atal Bihari Vajpayee was a friend of mine. He was not a representative of the political party which I know, whom I knew, but a person very open, affectionate, and since he belonged to a party, and I used to say, "You are a good person but in a wrong party." So he said, "Tell me which party should I join?" But anyway, but Atal Bihari Vajpayee, I remember when we went to Lahore in the bus, that was his, I would say, the finest hour. And there he tried his best to have good relations with Pakistan, durable. But Pakistan had a different agenda at that time also at all. They, first thing they did was to ask him, discuss Kashmir. He said, "I don't mind discussing Kashmir, let's discuss all problems." And it was very sad that the three service chiefs who were present there from Pakistan, none of them saluted Vajpayee ji. He was our prime minister, so I don't know. So I registered these things with Prime Minister Nawazshif, who was then also prime minister. And Prime Minister Nawazshif, I must say, he said, "I admit all these things, but since we have just broken the ice, I think we shall go along." But I said, "This is as to start with."
Okay, all right. Thank you so much, Mr. Nayar. I'm going to come back to you, of course, for further reactions from you as far as your friendship with the former Prime Minister is concerned. Let me bring in Ms. Chowdhury into the picture. Now, Ms. Chowdhury, who were the tall leaders of that time? And what was their significance in this 13-day government?
I think the tall leaders were, of course, Vajpayee, Advani, 96 were all these people who subsequently became Ramakrishnan Hegde, Deva Goda, I.K. Gujral, and a whole battery of, you know, from the Congress side, Narasimha Rao, Rajesh Pilot, Balram Jakhar, Sharad Pawar. So there was a huge battery of leaders at that time, tall leaders. And because the BJP had emerged as the single largest party, and I remember, you know, because we used to cover and write, this sticks in my mind that Vajpayee was not sure that they would be called. Ashok ji may remember this, that they were really not sure that they would actually be invited. And he deserved to be prime minister, but he was not sure that opportunity would actually come by or give him a slip. And he was, of course, there was humility in the man. So then the party was called, he formed the government, 13-day government lasted, major decisions faced them. Narasimha Rao had got the nuclear device ready and track two, he had conveyed to Mr. Vajpayee that you can actually go in for an explosion, but the cabinet secretary had ruled that out, that since the party had not got a majority on the floor of the house, you couldn't take a big decision like that. There was a major thing about Enron, I remember. At that time. So, I mean, it was a very turbulent era, and yet it was an extraordinary thing that you had this 13-day government being there, party asked to form government, not able to form government. Then there was a group that cobbled together a majority, a United Front government came into being, these regional parties.
With the Congress's support from the
outside. And the Congress supported from outside, and these regional parties banded together and used to be called the government of the chief ministers. Mm-hmm. And that they took hold of things. But you know, all this happened without any violence, without any, very smoothly. And I remember, people outside used to marvel at this, how India could go in for transition of government, change of guard, without any resistance, and even though you did not have a majority and without any violence. So there's something
three prime ministers in the span of 2 years.
That's right, in 2 years, absolutely.
Sure. Mr. Tandon, what role did Mr. Vajpayee play at that point in time, and how did he try to cobble up, the numbers to try and form the majority at that point in time?
So, see, before we come to 1996, we have to go back to 1977, when the first non-Congress government was formed at the center under the leadership of Morarji Desai, when Janata Party was formed. In 1980, when Indira Gandhi came back to power and the Janata Party split, it split into so many parties, including the JDS, which is today we in Karnataka, and then in the aftermath of the Ram Temple movement, or if I may say the reservation issue also, when BJP became the single largest party in 1996, it was in fact perceived as untouchable party by all non-Congress outfits as well. And therefore, as Neerja was also saying, when President Shankar Dayal Sharma started the process of inviting leaders to form the government, obviously Mr. Vajpayee was the first to be called. As she has also said, Vajpayee never expected that Dr. Shankar Dayal Sharma will hand over a letter to him, appointing him as the Prime Minister and then asking him to prove his majority on the floor of the House. So it was a big dilemma for the then BJP leadership what to do, because they didn't have numbers, but they were the single largest party, and the party went into a huddle. And at that time, it was Pramod Mahajan particularly who insisted that, yes, we must take a plunge. Let's at least form a government so that people should not say that BJP is always a supporting party, it can never form a government. And then a decision was taken, knowing fully well that they didn't have the number.
Right.
And rightly so, when the matter came up before Parliament and Mr. Vajpayee resigned, and the 13-day government fell, and subsequently two UPA governments were formed. But that laid the foundation stone for the 1990 election, in which Mr. Vajpayee was sworn in as the Prime Minister for the second time. This time round, remarkable personality of Mr. Vajpayee, that the party which was untouchable in the 1996 election, even his close friends in many opposition parties were scared of supporting Vajpayee on the floor of the House because the party was perceived as untouchable. Mm. But by the time he reached 1998 election, where again party emerged as the single largest party, but on the eve of that, an NDA was formed. And many NDA partners were, including George Fernandez and many others who were from different background. But the fact remains, 1998 was different from 1996.
Okay.
An NDA was formed, that is how they came to power, although that government also did not last beyond 13 months. But the fact remains that in his third government in 1999, you know, who were in the NDA as cabinet colleagues of Mr. Vajpayee? Mr. George Fernandez, Mamata Banerjee, Naveen Patnaik, Nitish Kumar, Sharad Yadav, you name the stalwarts. They were all...
Was Bhupinder also part of the...
No. Okay. Bhupinder was not. Then from DMK and AIADMK also. But they look at the transformation which he brought from 1996 to 1998 and then to 1999. And that is how that government survived full term.
Sure.
So I think the question which you asked was, the era of coalition government was started in 1996 with Mr. Vajpayee, which continued from 1998, then 1999, and subsequently Congress came to power. That was also a coalition government. And by the time we had a coalition era, all political pundits have started saying the coalition era has come to stay in Indian politics. No party can get the majority in parliament in future. And surprisingly, in 2014, that trend was reversed again.
Okay.
But still, even today, Narendra Modi government is a coalition.
Coalition
government.
At the end of the day, it is the NDA government.
It's an NDA government,
and not the BJP government. Thank you for that lesson in history, Mr. Tandon. Mm-hmm. Very nicely put. Thank you for taking us back 22 years as well. Dipinder Singh Hooda, former Chief Minister of Haryana, senior Congress leader, and he was also part of the 11th Lok Sabha in 1996. He too is with us on the program. Hooda Saab, namaskar. Firstly, us samay ka mahol kaisa tha? What was the economic and political situation at that point in time?
देखिए 96 की बात कर रहे हैं आप, अटल बिहारी जी सिंगल लार्जेस्ट पार्टी को हेड कर रहे थे और उनको राष्ट्रपति जी ने इनवाइट किया, डॉक्टर शंकरानंद जी ने. उस टाइम बीजेपी को ये उम्मीद नहीं थी, लेकिन दैट वाज अ शॉर्ट लिफ्ट. 13 दिन या 14 दिन की गवर्नमेंट थी और वो मतलब अपना कॉन्फ्रेंस नहीं ले पाई, मेजोरिटी नहीं ले पाई, तो अटल बिहारी जी हैड टू रिजाइन. एंड आफ्टर दैट देव गौड़ा जी बिकेम प्राइम मिनिस्टर, फिर गुजराल साहब बने, फिर गुजराल साहब हैज टू गो बिकॉज ऑफ डीएमके विथड्रू ऑन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस जैन इंक्वायरी कमीशन रिपोर्ट वाज नॉट लेड ऑन द रिपोर्ट वाज नॉट लेड हाउस में. और फिर इलेक्शन हुआ 98 में, अगेन अटल बिहारी जी बिकेम प्राइम मिनिस्टर. एंड देन इन 99 again he lost vote of confidence by one vote. As far as the era of coalition is concerned, you have to go back to 1967. That was the start.
But in 1967, sir, it was only in the states.
One after another, they started forming the government in states.
Yes.
Not in the center.
Yeah.
So that started from states and it came to center. If you go back to 89, Congress was the largest party headed by Rajiv Gandhi ji, but he did not claim this formation of government. Rashtrapati ji ke paas unhone apna dawa nahi rakha, and that is how VP Singh ji became, unki jyada majority thi members ki, and after that Chandrasekhar became, then because that goes on in 91, Narasimha Rao began, and that was a stable part. After that, when Vajpayee ji became second time, so it was also stable government, and then followed by Manmohan Singh ji government for 10 years. Now it is also a coalition. From that day, it is almost a coalition government.
Sure.
So that era is started like this.
So the coalition era started back then in 1996 is what Hooda Saab is saying.
No, I don't think it started in 1996. It started in 1977.
But
as
in states
said,
it started in 67.
Sure, yeah. Yes. Well, yes, point taken.
In 77, mein, jab all these parties merged together to take on the Congress after the emergency was lifted. So that was first Janata Party government that came. But then 1989 was well and truly the coalition government.
Nirjaji, that was also type of a coalition government.
That's right, Hooda Saab. So the Congress...
That was also
Congress had got 197 seats. Rajiv Gandhi turned down the offer that he couldn't form the government. VP Singh headed government was formed, and it was a very unique experiment of Janata Dal as the centerpiece and the BJP and the left supporting this government from outside. So they had the right and the left and the center, all the non-Congress forces to defeat the Congress.
Sure.
And the Congress has really never recovered after that.
Okay.
The body blow that VP Singh inflicted on the Congress, the Congress never come back with the majority.
We'll get Hooda saab to respond to that in just a bit.
There is another guest. In political science terms, I don't know if I am not wrong. Coalition is when you join the government. In the 89 experiment, the Congress and to VP Singh government, BJP and the left, where they were supporting from outside. That way even Chandrasekhar government was the first coalition government in which other parties had joined the government. In the case of Congress, Congress only supported it from outside. Even BJP and the left supported VP Singh government from outside. They never participated in it. So I don't think we can technically call it coalition.
Yeah, maybe then you say minority government, minority, which was propped up by the right.
The term is minority government.
Let me bring in V. Dhananjay Kumar too, who's joining us on the phone line from Bengaluru. Dhananjay Kumar, Ore, welcome. And you know, as far as 1996 is concerned, you have to give us a history lesson there. You were part of that particular government. You were the civil aviation minister at that point in time. Why couldn't the government survive? What happened? Only 13 days, what were the problems? What were the biggest challenges that you were facing at that point in time?
Frank, as you are quite aware, Atal Bihari Vajpayee headed the Bharatiya Janata Party, 166 seats in the Lok Sabha. So apparently, the party didn't have the numbers to prove majority on the floor of the house. But the Honorable President of India, Dr. Shankar Dayal Sharma, in the process of forming the government, since no party had absolute majority on the floor of the house, he started the process of formation of a government. And in that process, he first invited Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, being the leader of the single largest party. And as was being mentioned by other guests there, Bharatiya Janata Party at that point of time took a decision that when an offer is made by the Honorable President, we should respect it. And we formed the government, knowing fully well that we will not be in a position to prove the majority. And the government itself will be a short-lived government. So that is why the first agenda that was set before the government, when the Lok Sabha met for the first time after the elections in 1996, the first agenda was to show that the government has the majority on the floor of the house. The confidence motion was moved by the Prime Minister himself. There was no confidence motion. It was a confidence motion moved by Honorable Prime Minister, which didn't get the majority support on the floor of the house. And as rightly mentioned by Mr. Ashok Tandon, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, being a statesman, he said on the floor of the house, I still remember as a part of that cabinet, that he said, Main chala Rashtrapati Bhavan, istifa dene. That was the words used by Atal Bihari Vajpayee.
Sure. Okay. Let me bring in Mr. Kuldip Nayar, who has been patiently listening to everything that's been happening over the 15 odd minutes. Mr. Kuldip Nayar, as far as the nation is concerned, how did it respond to the first BJP government to have ever been formed in 1996?
Atal ji was very particular to say that he was a Nehruite, a follower of Jawaharlal Nehru. I remember I was in the house then, the Rajya Sabha. He invited me to his room, Prime's room, and the first thing he said, see that chair, this chair in which I am sitting, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru used to sit here. So he was very particular about that. Now, as far as his, correct, he was in the BJP at the time, but never did I find anything in him which would in any way reflect on the secular character of the of our polity. And all the time, he was very much wanting to have good relations with Pakistan. And at that time, Pakistan was not Bangladesh also, but only Pakistan. And he went to any extent that if he could have good relations, he went to also Lahore, but Pakistan had a different agenda at that time. It's this Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, who is now the Prime Minister, was then the Prime Minister, and he very privately told me, told him that Atalji, hamara agenda ye nahi hai, aap phir kabhi is baat pe koi sulah ho sakti hai. So that was, but Atalji, even though they were hostile, everything, he continued his efforts to have good relations with Pakistan, and that should reflect in India also, so that people shouldn't be divided into Muslims, Hindus, Sikh, but we are all Indians, and political parties are there, one not the other, but that shouldn't divide us.
Okay, all right. Taking the discussion forward now, Mr. Tandon, what were the circumstances that led the Sangh Parivar to form a political wing?
To form a
political wing and a political party?
Oh, well, I think in the aftermath of Mahatma Gandhi's assassination, RSS was banned, and the RSS viewpoint could not be put across to the people through proper channel, and they became victims, although the Kapoor Commission has absolved the RSS of any such wrongdoing. But at that time, there was a feeling that even RSS is a social cultural organization. If it doesn't have any say in the legislatures and the forum of the people, then its case may be defeated by default. So in that process, at that time, Dr. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee, who was a minister in the interim cabinet of Jawaharlal Nehru, and he approached the RSS to float a political party, and the RSS agreed to do that, and it lent some of its veteran pracharaks like Dindyal Upadhyay, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and many others to join politics, and that is how the Jan Sangh was formed, and which subsequently merged Jan Sangh into Janata Party during the JP movement. And then after the Janata Party split, it became Bharatiya Janata Party, and that is how the journey started. And we all know in 84 it was reduced only to 2 seats, and then from there the party went on, and in 1996, which we are discussing today, it emerged as the single largest party, defeating the Congress Party, which has been dominating the Indian political scene for decades. And that is how the question of forming the first non-Congress government, at least a first BJP government, came up. And in the process, many RSS workers joined the political field, and they are still there. Even Vajpayee also was a pracharak of the RSS. So is Mr. Narendra Modi today. See, the journey of the Jan Sangh, which started, as I said earlier, has now reached a stage where in 2014, again, the party emerges as a majority party, absolute majority in election, and still it continues to be an NDA with all its partners. Many have left in the Vajpayee era. The number, starting from 13 coalition partners, went on to become, I don't know, even 21 or 22.
24, I remember.
24. Many used to leave and others joined, like if the AIADMK left, then the DMK would join, like that. But now look at the party, which is perhaps the biggest political party, which membership, if you look at it, is the perhaps the biggest party in the world.
Okay.
And now it's ruling in almost 20-21 states.
Sure.
So the journey, which you asked the question, why it started, because they wanted that their ideology should be reflected through the representative of the people and at the proper forum of the public representatives.
Okay. Hooda Saab, you know, as far as the opposition back then is concerned in the late 90s, you know, what were your biggest challenges at that point in time and how did you tackle them?
That was, you see, after 96 elections, Congress jo hai, kaafi log chhodne lag gaye the. Then we requested Shrimati Sonia Gandhi. We started requesting her to be active in politics. So after when she became active, the Congress majboot ho gayi, ek ho gayi, aur workers mein bhi thoda hausla aaya, aur Congress is saaf se aate aate 2005 mein it came to the power. That is how. And you see, I've seen 98 also, jab Gujral ji had to resign and elections mein gaye, uske baad 98 mein jab Atal Bihari ji bane, aur ek vote se inki sarkar giri because of pehle hua DMK, I think AIDMK withdrew the support from Atal Bihari ji aur pone 11 baje kareeb ye khabar thi hamare central hall mein ki Mayawati ji support karengi Atal Bihari ji ko, but when she spoke she opposed government, so is tarah vote padi aur Mr. Gomango, who was the chief minister of Odisha us time और एमपी भी थे, तो उनकी वोट के ऊपर भी काफ़ी डिस्कशन हुआ उसमें, लेकिन अल्टीमेटली वोटेड एंड दैट गवर्नमेंट लॉस्ट बाय वन वोट एंड दैट क्रिएटेड सिंपथी फॉर मिस्टर अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी एंड आफ्टर कारगिल आल्सो एंड दैट इज हाउ अगेन इट केम टू पावर एंड ही रिमेन्ड प्राइम मिनिस्टर अप टू 2004. लेकिन जितने देर भी प्राइम मिनिस्टर है, हम अपोजिशन से थे, अटल बिहारी जी के साथ बड़े मधुर संबंध रहे हमारे. कभी भी होता था कोई भी इशू हम लेके जाते थे, तो ही यूज टू ऑलवेज वेलकम और अच्छे मतलब उसमें रहते थे एंड ही यूज टू सी लाइक ए स्टेट्समैन. ही ऑलवेज बिहेव लाइक ए स्टेट्समैन, नो डाउट अबाउट इट.
जी नीरज चौधरी, एज फार एज द 90s वर कंसर्न, 1996 डू यू बिलीव वॉज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ अ न्यू ईरा ऑफ इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स?
I would say it was the most turbulent era in recent times of Indian politics. I don't know what is in store for us. It went into coalition era, which was difficult to manage, not so simple, with smaller parties demanding their pound of flesh at every turn from the big party that was the centerpiece of the government. This happened with NDA, this happened with UPA, even with Atalji. I remember he renounced his finance minister and within hours of taking over he had to undo that choice. So such were the pressures and the buffeting around, but these men handled it. And of course there was the liberalization, opening up of the economy in 91, there was the nuclear explosion, there was you know, as I said, Kargil and a new outreach to Pakistan that was made by the Lahore Yatra made by Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and the fault lines of Mandal and Mandir, which have changed the course of Indian politics and which remain with us even to today, that got started and unleashed, really speaking, in the early 90s.
Sure.
So yes, it has what happened in the decade of the 90s has influenced in Indian politics irreversibly.
Okay, all right. Let me now get a final closing comment in from Mr. Nayar. Mr. Nayar, do leave us with a fond memory of, yes, Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Your fondest memory.
I was in London as India's High Commissioner. Atal ji came to London. And those were the days when Babri Masjid, the Ayodhya Mandir was very much in the news. So I asked Atal ji, why haven't you here? Why haven't you gone to Ayodhya? So he said, "Arey bhai, jo Ram Bhagat hain, wo to gaye Ayodhya, aur jo Desh Bhagat hain, wo London aa gaye." This was it. So I recall that Atal ji. Recall lots of things, but one thing he said at that time, and I am so sorry that he is not well at all. He did say ही सेड भाई तुम लोग कोई नई पार्टी शुरू करो, हम भी तुम्हें ज्वाइन करेंगे, जो ये हिंदू मुस्लिम या दूसरी चीज़ें इसमें ना पड़े, ना ही वो कुछ इकॉनमी हार्डन हो और ना ही कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें हों जिससे कि लोगों को दूर किया जाए या बांटा जाए, ये मैं जाता हूँ।
ओके, ऑल राइट, ऑन दैट नोट देन वी विल कॉल इट अ रैप ऑन दिस एडिशन ऑफ द बिग पिक्चर। आई'd लाइक टू थैंक ऑल माय गेस्ट्स फॉर जॉइनिंग मी ऑन द प्रोग्राम एंड पुटिंग थिंग्स इनटू पर्सपेक्टिव फॉर अस वेटरन गेस्ट्स ऑन द प्रोग्राम टुडे, गिविंग अस अ लेसन इन हिस्ट्री। दैट्स इट फ्रॉम मी, सी यू अगेन नेक्स्ट टाइम।